Hello! Today I'm going to show you how to convert an 8-foot long fluorescent fixture into a LED fixture. To do this job, we're going to need 2 wire nuts, a flat blade screwdriver, a pair of wire cutters, and a pair of wire strippers. The first step is to find the switch that turns the light on and off. I think I found it. This is the one. So now we're going to find the breaker that turns off the light. Pretty sure it's this one. Just to be extra sure that we got the right breaker, I'm going to flip the light switch on and off and verify that the light doesn't come on. Okay, we're going to take the LED bulbs out of their containers because we want to make room in these containers for the fluorescent bulbs. The fluorescent bulbs are fragile, they're made out of glass, and if you break them, you end up with mercury all over the place. So we really want to protect them with these handy cardboard tubes that the LED bulbs came in. So the first step is to remove the LED bulbs and get these ready to handle the fluorescent bulbs. Okay, the first step is to take the old glass fluorescent light bulbs out of the fixture. These are in place on a spring-loaded kind of arrangement, so you have to push the bulb in one direction and then you can release it from the socket here. And then you want to be careful that you don't drop it because these are made out of glass and full of mercury. Okay, I want to be really careful with these fragile glass tubes that have mercury in them, so I'm going to immediately put this into the cardboard tube that the LED bulb came in. And that way, we minimize the chance that it will break it and cause all kinds of problems. To secure it, we want to put a little duct tape around the outside of the cap, because otherwise it could potentially slide off and the tube could come out and break. Okay, now we have one of the bulbs put away in a protective cardboard case. Now we're going to take the other bulb out. Again, this is a spring-loaded situation, so you want to be at the end of the fixture that doesn't have the spring. Now you can tell which end of the fixture has a spring by the way it looks. This is the spring end of the fixture. The way you can tell is that you have this narrow piece sticking out of the base of the connector, and that's narrower because it has to slide inside of the wider part. So this is the spring end of the fixture, and this is not the end of the fixture that you want to remove the bulb from. You want to remove the bulb from the other end of the fixture. Okay, here we are back at the non-spring end of the fixture, and I'm going to push towards the spring end of the fixture to release the bulb from here, and then I carefully take it down. Okay, and immediately I'm going to put this tube away, this fragile glass tube filled with mercury. I'm going to put this in the cardboard sleeve that the LED bulb came in, and I'm going to cap it. Okay, so I'm going to secure the cap with some duct tape so that I don't have to worry about the tube sliding out when I transport this to the recycling station. Okay, the next step is to remove the covers. In this case, you have a little latch that you twist, and then you can remove the covers. I'm using a pair of pliers to open the cover of the fixture because there are sharp edges involved. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to cut the wires that go into the ballast as close to the ballast as possible. Okay, we cut 3 wires on the far end of the ballast. On this end, there's just 2 wires. And now we're done with cutting. These ballasts are held in usually with just one fastener, in this case a screw, and it's a flathead screw. And then they just slide out like this. Okay, the ballast that we cut out had 5 wires going to it.
a white, a black, two blues, and a red. This red wire goes to one end of the fixture, and these two blue wires go to the other end of the fixture. So I'll show you that next.
This is one end of the fixture. As you can see, it's connected only by the red wire. These new LED bulbs require 110 volts connected from one end of the bulb to the other. So we're going to put one side of the 110 volts AC on this red wire. So here we are at the other end of the fixture. These connectors here, the spring-loaded ones that we saw earlier, they are fed by the blue wire. So the other side of the 110 volts AC, we want to connect to the blue wire. In this case, instead of just a single red wire, we've got two blue wires, but fundamentally, they just feed these connectors here. Okay, so here we have the five wires that were hooked up to the ballast. We now know that the red wire goes to one end of the fixture, the blue wire supplies electricity to the other end of the fixture, and the white and black wire here, this is the electricity coming from the grid. So the ballast that we had in here was energized by the white and black wire. It did its voltage regulation thing and then sent that out to the light bulb through the red and the blue wires. But the LED light bulb has all the ballast circuitry built right into it. So we're going to end up just connecting the red wire to the white wire and the blue wires to the black wire. In order to make these connections, I'm going to have to strip all five of these wires, which is what I'm doing now. So now that I've stripped the wires, I'm going to connect the red and the white together. So once you've got the two wires, one next to the other, and even, so the ends are even, you take the wire nut, slip it over, and twist it on. And you want to twist it until you feel it bite and get it nice and snug. And then you can test to see that you made a good connection by making sure the wires don't pop out. Okay, so now we did the red and white wire. We hooked those together. Now we're going to hook up the black and the two blues. So what we need to do first is get the wires so that they're all even next to each other and where the ends are all even one with the other. Then we slip the cap over those wires. So now that we have the cap on there, we want to twist it clockwise and it'll snug up. You'll feel it get tight. And you don't want to overdo it, of course, but you want to make sure it's nice and snug, and then you want to test to make sure you have a good connection by tugging on the wires, each one individually, make sure they don't come out of the wire nut. These holes here receive these tabs from the cover. So you want to make sure that when you replace the cover, you've got those tabs in those holes. Okay, we're going to put the cover on, get the tabs into the holes, and then we hinge it up. And we'll make sure that the wires get tucked in, they don't stick out. And okay, now we want to close the cover, making sure that the wires are all tucked in there nicely. And then we turn that latch so that the cover is held in place. And we're going to do the same thing at the other side of the fixture. The tabs go into the holes. Okay, and then we hinge the cover into place, making sure the wires are tucked in. And then we rotate the latch and we're done. Now it's time to insert the LED bulb into the fixture. Okay, so the first step is to put the bulb into the spring end of the socket. And then, keeping pressure on it, you raise it up. You raise the bulb into place, and then push against the spring and then let it go into the socket here. And now I'm going to put in the second bulb. Okay, and now we're ready to re-energize the circuit by flipping the breaker back on. And now I'm going to turn the lights on.
And that's how you convert spring-loaded fluorescent tube lighting fixtures to LEDs, which use less than half the wattage and last for 40,000 to 50,000 hours. It's time to convert.